Good morning, class. In this video, we'll be studying about four topics. We'll be studying scalar quantities, vector quantities, uniform motion, and non-uniform motion. Okay, so let's begin. Our first topic is scalar quantity. Now, in the previous videos, we have studied different kinds of we have studied quantities like distance, displacement, velocity, speed. These are the four physical quantities that we have studied. Now, what is physical quantity? A quantity which requires only magnitude or a number for its description is called what? Physical quantity. For example, we have studied with various examples in the previous videos that if we go from A to B, then from B to C, and then from C to A, we are covering, let us suppose, 4 meter, 5 meter, 3 meter, 4 meter, and 5 meter. So if we are actually counting the actual length of the path, then that quantity was called what? Distance. 3 plus 4 is 7, 7 plus 5 is 12. So this is what distance is. So if you go from this direction, see, 3, 4, 5, it will be what? 12 meter. Now you go from this direction, again you will be having 5, 4, 9, 9, and 3, 12. So does distance depend upon the direction? No, it is independent of the direction. You move clockwise, you move anti-clockwise, it will be same. So a quantity which depends only on magnitude and it is independent of direction is called what? A scalar quantity. So what is scalar quantity? A scalar quantity is a quantity. You can write it in short form. Scalar quantity is a quantity which is defined by both magnitude plus direction. Okay, you can define it yourself. I'm just explaining the equation. A scalar quantity is a quantity which is defined only by its magnitude and not by its direction, because we are not accepting the direction here. Okay. Now, so we have got the concept as quantity which is independent of direction and which depends only upon the magnitude is called scalar quantity. Example for scalar quantity is what? Distance. Okay. Distance. Okay. Got my point? So, this is the one example for scalar quantity. Now, I'll give you another example for scalar quantity, which is dependent only upon what? Magnitude and not direction. So, second example for scalar quantity is speed, which is distance upon time, which is distance upon time. Okay. So, if distance is a scalar quantity, so speed will also be what? Scalar quantity. For example, you move from A to B with a speed of 2 meter per second. And you move from B to A again with same speed, 2 meter per second. So does your speed changes when you are changing the direction? No, it will be 2 meter per second. For example, if you are moving on a scooter or a bike or aviator or a car or anything, so you keep your accelerator at a constant rate, hai na? So it will be 2 meter per second in this direction, it will be 2 meter per second in this direction. So it is independent of direction. So if distance is scalar quantity, then speed is also a scalar quantity. It is dependent only on magnitude, so it is again dependent on magnitude. It is independent of direction, it is again independent of direction. So we got this concept now. A physical quantity which depends only on magnitude, this is called magnitude, this is magnitude 2, and this is unit. So which is dependent only upon magnitude and not on direction, that is called what? A scalar quantity. Okay, got my point? So we have completed this. Now we'll move to second heading, vector quantity. We'll move to second heading, it is what? Vector quantity. Now vector quantity is just addition of direction. Vector quantity is what? When we add magnitude plus direction. A quantity which depends on both magnitude and direction is called what? Vector quantity. Now I'll give you the answer. I'll give you the example. Suppose if I tell you to follow the shortest path from A to C. So you know you can follow this path. 3 plus 4, you'll reach C. It will be 7 meter. And if you go from A to C, it will be 5 meter. So what is the shortest path? This is the shortest path. But for this path, you need to know the shortcut. The shortcut is you need to know that there is a shortest road present between A and B. So this is the direction. So if I am to write displacement, this is the displacement term. So displacement is a vector quantity. Displacement is a vector quantity. Displacement is vector quantity. And the magnitude was 5 meter. And the direction was A to C. This is the direction. So this is magnitude, this is direction. So a quantity defined by both magnitude and direction is called what? Vector quantity. Okay, we have got this concept now. A scalar quantity depends only upon magnitude. Vector quantity depends both on magnitude and direction. Okay, so another example for vector quantity will be what? Velocity. Suppose we are having velocity. Velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Okay, velocity is equal to displacement upon time. So we have just defined ki if displacement is vector quantity, then velocity will also be what? Vector quantity. How I'll explain you now with example. Suppose this is A point, this is B point, and this is C point. Okay, we have taken 3 points. Okay, this is origin 0 meter, this is 2 meter, and this is in negative direction, so I am taking it in minus 2 meter. Okay, so this direction is positive, this direction is negative. Okay, so if we move from A to B, so we are calculating velocity. Velocity of the formula for velocity is what? Displacement upon time. So displacement from A to B is what? 2 meter. And suppose we have taken 2 seconds. So upon time. So 2 meter upon 2 seconds give 1 meter per second. Okay, so this is positive. So positive 1 meter per second in moving from A to B. This is the direction which I was talking about. This is the magnitude for velocity and this is the direction. Okay. Now you move the same distance but in opposite direction. Suppose you are moving now from A to C. Displacement upon time. Displacement is again same. It is minus 2 now because we have taken the direction, because displacement is a vector quantity. We need to have what? Direction. Okay. So if I am to move from A to C. Displacement will be what? Minus 2 meter. And time is again 2 seconds. So this time if I am calculating velocity, it is coming out to be minus 1 meter per second. But you see, you can clearly see this direction. This is the direction. So this negative direction, this negative sign indicates that you have moved in opposite direction. Okay. So this is what velocity is, which depends upon your direction. So velocity is a example for a vector quantity. Displacement is another example for vector quantity, which depends upon both magnitude and direction. See, you can write minus 1 meter per second in two ways. Either you can write minus 1, so it is clear that it is moving from A to C, or you can write 1 meter per second from A to C. These are the two ways in which you can write. Okay, so we have got this concept now. A scalar quantity is a quantity which depends only on magnitude and it is independent of direction. Two examples of scalar quantities are speed and distance. A quantity which depends on both magnitude and direction is what? Vector quantity. And the example for those two are, for that the quantity is what? Displacement and velocity. And if it is, suppose we have just calculated minus 1. Minus 1 is indicating the direction you are moving in opposite direction. And if you don't want to use the negative sign, just you have to then to mention that it is moving from A to C. So a quantity with magnitude and direction is called vector quantity. Okay. So we got this concept now. We have completed two topics. Now we will move to the next topic, that is uniform motion. Uniform motion. Okay, class. So I'll explain you with the help of example. Suppose a body moved 2 meter in 1 second. Okay, it covered 2 meter in 1 second. Then it covered another 2 meter. So 2 plus 2 what? 4 meter. In another 1 second. So 1 plus 1 is what? 2 seconds. And similarly, 6 meter, 8 meter, 3 second, 4 second. So it is covering equal distance in equal interval of time. This is called uniform motion. So if I am calculating speed, speed is distance upon time. 2 meter per second, 2 meter per second, and similarly, same. It will be same. Okay. So what is uniform motion? When body covers equal distance in equal interval of time, then that motion is called what? Uniform motion. Okay, got my concept? This is as simple as it can be. Okay. It is nothing more but a constant speed. So what is uniform motion? In which the speed of body is constant. So what we can write in uniform motion? Speed of body is constant. Okay. And another definition, you can write it yourself. When body covers equal distance in equal interval of time. Okay, so the concept is important. You can make your definitions in your own word. And the length of the definition doesn't matter. The language of the definition doesn't matter, as long as you are sticking to the point. Okay, so this is uniform motion. Now, our last heading, non-uniform motion. So it is just antonym of what? Uniform motion. So suppose here body covered. Suppose the graph is same, but I'm just, the table is same. I'm just twisting some digits. Suppose body covered 2 meter in 2 seconds. Now it covers 6 meter in again in 1 second. Then in again in another 1 second. So 2 seconds it covered 6 meter. Then it covered 8 meter in 1 second. So here it is covering 4 meter. 2 plus 4 6. But here it is covering 2 meter. So this is unequal increase. First, in the previous example, it was increasing by equal amount. But here it is increasing by unequal amount. 4, 2. So speed will not be constant. So if you calculate the speed here, 2 upon 1, it will be 2 meter per second. If you calculate the speed here, it will be how much distance it has covered from 2 to 6 meter. 4 meter. Okay. So it has covered 4 meter. So it will be what? 4 upon 2. It will be what? 2 meter per second. So the idea is ki it is covering unequal distancing equal interval of time. So this is what uniform motion is. Okay, so I hope you got all the concept. The simple I have just explained you in the most simplest and precise manner it can be. So you can write the definition yourself, and if you have any doubt, you can leave in the comment box. Okay, thanks for watching.